Amen. Let the church say amen. Amen. Let the church say amen again. Amen. We welcome you today to our worship experience as we celebrate in this Advent season, the third Sunday of joy. And we are thankful today for the joy of Jesus. We welcome you virtually and in person. And at this time, we will have the Vance family to lead us in our Advent litany. Brother Vance and Darlene Vance.
Good morning. Good morning. God has purpose, God has plan.
God prophet has spoken.
Today we gather for the third Sunday of Advent.
Advent season of expectation, season of anticipation, season of expectation.
For God has purpose that humanity sent into the world as atonement for our sin of waywardness.
And we just want to recite the Mary said, I'm so magnified, the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. But he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely, for now, all the generation will call me blessed. The mighty one has done great things for me. And holy is his name.
Today we remember Mary, who at any time throughout the process finds herself innocent and powerful, scared and scared, worried and waiting, and the Savior of all grows in her womb. She sings boldly when she might be meek, bears her role in history with the confidence of a warrior, and finds herself at the forefront of a mighty counter-cultural revolution as the high are brought low and the low are lifted high.
Today we give thanks for the Marys among us, those who step out of the role society has planned, those unintended pioneers determined to do what thus says the Lord, those who both fearlessly and fearfully step out in faith, and in so doing call us to do the same.
Church say amen. Ushers, you may allow our worshipers to come in, and thank you, Brother and Sister Vance. Don't you feel the power? And isn't that beautiful? Let the church say amen. Come on, let's give God some praise. As God has ushered in the spirit of Advent into this place, and the spirit of joy is in this house. And it's because of the love of Jesus the Christ that we celebrate today in worship his holy name. Holy name, for he is worthy to be praised. Please join me in the celebration of Advent this morning by singing our doxology. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow.
Thank you.
rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. We come to worship and rejoice. Let your gladness be known to everyone. The Lord is near, and we come to worship and rejoice the one who is with us, Emmanuel. Go tell it on the mountain. Go tell it on the mountain. Over the hills and everywhere, go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Let us sing with uplifting voices as the choir will lead us. Go tell it on the mountain. Invocation will be given by Reverend Moses Crocker and our scripture by Reverend Patricia McGathy.
Praise the Lord. Come on, give God some praise in this house today. Come on, somebody know he's worthy to be praised. Glory to the God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Bow your heads with me this morning. We just come to thank God this morning. We come to lift up the name of Jesus in this sanctuary. Oh, God, we got so much to be thankful for in this season, God. Oh, God, we just cry out to you this morning, Lord God. Somebody needs you this morning, God. Somebody needs your spirit in this house this morning, God. Somebody just been crying out all night long looking for an answer, looking for a way to be made. Oh, God, looking for the help, and you know, all that help coming from you, Lord. God, we just thank you this morning, Jesus. Oh, God, we just come to say thank you this morning, Jesus. Oh, God, we just come to lift up the name of Jesus in this sanctuary this morning, God. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you this morning, God. We praise you this morning, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, glory to God. We just thank you this morning, God. We just ask that you send a word this morning, God. We need to hear from your throne this morning, God. We need to hear from heaven, God, in this troubled time, in this time, in this season right now, God. There's so much going on right now. Oh, God, somebody needs you this morning, Lord. God, I need a touch this morning, Jesus. Oh, God, I need you to move right now, God, by your spirit, Lord. Oh, God, I can't do it all by myself, God. I'm counting on you to do it for me this morning, God. Oh, if I just had two or three just can touch and agree with me this morning. Oh, God, it's spiritual prayer this morning, God. We need a touch this morning, God. Oh, God, I need you this morning, Lord. I can't do nothing without you, God. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Touch the saints of God, Lord. Touch the people of God in this sanctuary, God. Touch the sick and the shut in this morning, God. Oh, God, somebody crying out to you this morning, Lord. Oh, God, somebody crying out to you this morning, God. Lord, I need you this morning, God. Can't do it without you, God. I need you this morning, Lord, in this sanctuary, God. We need a word, God. We need you to anoint the man of God, Lord. Pour out of him this morning, God. Somebody need one thing and somebody need another, Lord. But God, we need a word this morning, God. We need direction and we need guidance, God. We need you to touch the homeless, the sick and the shut in this morning, God. Oh, God, somebody laying on their bed of affliction this morning, God. Looking for you to send your angels, God. Oh, God, raise them up this morning, God. Only you can do it, God. We thank you in this sanctuary this morning, God. Come to lift you up this morning, God. We need you this morning, Lord. Oh, in the name of Jesus. God, we just thank you, God. Touch the choir this morning. Let them sing, God. Oh, God, right now in the name of Jesus, God. Touch the dancers this morning, God. Let them dance unto the glory of God, Lord. Let us have an experience, God. Oh, God, an unnatural experience, God. A supernatural experience this morning, God. We ask that you move in this place, God. Touch our pastor, God. Touch the man of God, God. Touch the hymn of his garment, God. Let him preach from Zion, God. We need to hear from heaven today, God. Oh, God, we don't want to hear a natural man. We want to hear a spiritual. Oh, God, a spiritual pouring out this morning, God. Oh, God, I need you this morning, God. I pressed this morning, God. It was a press, God, getting in this house this morning, Lord. Oh, God, somebody had one thing, somebody did another, God, but it was a press. And, God, our coming is not in vain. Our coming is not in vain, Lord. But, God, we ask that you send a word, anoint the man of God, Lord, and have your way in this sanctuary today, God. Touch, like I said, the sick and the shut in. Somebody needs you this morning, God. I need you. I thank you this morning, God. Have your way in this sanctuary, Lord. Pour out among all flesh, God, your spirit, God. In Jesus' holy name, we ask all these things, Lord. Amen.
Praise God for everyone who's here this morning. And as those who are coming in are being seated, our selected scripture this morning is in your bulletin. From the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 through 10. In those days, Caesar Augusta issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths, and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring good news that will cause great joy for all people. This is the word of the Lord to the people of God, and we give thanks unto God." Amen.
Amen. Let the church say amen. Amen. Let the church say amen again. As we prepare now for our ministry of giving, we want to thank everyone who have had the spirit of giving and have shared with the St. Stephen Church and Benevolent for our outreach ministries that we have been able to do during this holiday season. So we thank you for your contributions, gift cards and contributions for our Senior Village Outreach Project on yesterday. And I want to thank all those persons who went over and shared blessings with our Senior Village, our neighbors across the street, and then those persons who share with our missionaries and our missionaries for our Angel Tree gifts to the children of those persons who are incarcerated and be a blessing to the family. So I thank you for your spirit of giving and generosity. Now as we prepare for stewardship today, pray that you would give as the Lord has blessed you, your commitment of your tithes and your offering and your Christmas offering and any other offerings that you have to bless the Lord, because it's more blessed to give than to receive. Before you on our screen, those persons who are worshiping with us virtually, is your method and way that you might be able to complete your stewardship this morning. As we prepare for our stewardship, those persons who are worshiping with us virtually and those persons who are in the sanctuary, if you need an envelope at this time, please raise your hand and an usher will serve you, and that you might be at the close of our worship service able to complete your worship experience for this season, for the spirit of giving. Let's give God some praise. Put your blessed hands together and give God some praise today. Give God some praise because he is true to his word. If you continue to trust him, he will continue to bless you. He's faithful. There have been many Christmases that I've had lean, but I praise God for those Christmases. because I continue to press my way. And God is faithful, and he will continue to be faithful. As the old folks used to say, I used to have to make do. Anybody know about making do? But guess what? Even with making do, I still had joy. The joy of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, put those between your hands. God, we're thankful today because you are a blessing and you are a blesser. We can never take you for granted, because when we reflect on where you brought us from and how you have kept us and how you have sustained us, we worship you today with gladness. With glad hearts, we worship you. We praise you because you've been good to us. And God, as we journey down to the end of 2023, some thought they weren't going to even make it this far. But we're here today, and we're thankful today. So we're going to worship you today. We're going to worship you today in spirit and in truth, with the dance, the song, and the word. We're going to declare and offer it all to you today, God, because you are the joy of this world. Thank you, God. Bless what's in our hands. Continue to trust us with even more, that we might be a greater blessing to your kingdom. In Jesus' name, and the church said, amen. Those who are worshiping with us online, you may complete your worship, and after the worship experience, we will, those in person, complete our worship experience. Just one time. Oh, come all ye faithful. Christ. Joyful. Church, say amen. And as we lift up our prayer list, those persons who are on our prayer list, we ask that you would build an altar right where you are, because we believe in the power of prayer. Right where you are on your pew is your altar. And today we lift up Sister Donna Jackson, who passing her mother. And the funeral services will be here at our church on Wednesday, the 27th, Mother Bing, and we will lift that family up in prayer. Sister Mary Holland, Sister Lisa Williams, Sister Christine Board, Deaconess Edwards, Sister Evelyn Grant, Sister Franny Austin, Brother Alfonso Hodges, Sister Frosty Felton, Sister Laura Toots, Brother Eddie Toots, Sister Patrice Love, Sister Priscilla Harris, Brother Charles Kahn, Brother and Sister Meriwether, Sister Marie Hightower, Sister Bernice Porter and Sister Brenda Holland, Mr. Jude Jones and Mr. Ronnie Burnett and baby Aaliyah Earl. We call their names and we speak healing and wholeness, and we stand firm on Isaiah, the 53rd chapter, when he said, he was wounded for our transgressions, abused for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace lie upon his shoulder and ask the minister music displaced off that Jesus is so real to me. Jesus is so real to me. He's real. God, we thank you today for the names I call and for the names I did not call. But there's those who are in the sanctuary who are interceding on their behalf. Lord, as we come down to the end of this year, we're thankful, God, for where you brought us from. And God, how you have kept us and how you've been with us and how you have sustained us. Nobody knows the troubles that we have seen, but we thank you, God, for being with us. We thank you, God, for watching over us and watching over our families and keeping us, God. You have kept us and you have brought us thus far. And we thank you so for all that you've done and all that you will do, God. Because, God, you have been real to us. You've been real to us. I know you're real, God. I can feel you moving right now in this sanctuary. I can feel you touching right now. And I thank you, God, for how you brought us thus far. How you have kept us and how you have sustained us. And we praise your holy name today. And we thank you in advance for what you're going to do in this worship experience. We lift up this consecrated choir to lead us in the ministry of music. Lift up the MCAM to lead us in dance. We lift up the man of God to lead us in word of God. And as we put this worship together, we thank you, God, for those who have come to worship you today. And as you prepare us right now, God, prepare our hearts to worship you. We just want to reflect on where you brought us from. Because if you brought us this far, and you kept us this far, we know, God, that you're going to keep us as we move into 2024. So thank you, God, for being real, to me. Amen. Let the church say amen. Amen. Let the church say amen again. Amen. As we prepare our hearts for the worship experience, the ministry of music presented to us by the Music and Christian Arts Ministry, and after they lead us in the ministry of music and dance, the homily will be given to us by the brother Jonathan Samuel, Holloway Jonathan Samuel. Let us prepare our hearts and minds as we prepare to worship God in the third Sunday of Advent, joy.
midnight clear, to bring joy to the world and to draw us near. It was a holy night when you came from above to fill our hearts with hope and love.
Thank you.
In the beginning was the one who is called the Word. The Word was with God and was truly God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to those who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, have the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human descent or a husband's will, but born of God.
Thank you.
walk in the dark have seen a bright light, and it shines upon everyone who lives in the land of darkest shadow. A child has been born for us. We have been given a son who will be our ruler. His names will be Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God, Eternal Father and Prince of Peace. His power will never end. Peace will last forever. He will rule David's kingdom and make it grow strong. He will always rule with honesty and justice. The Lord all-powerful will make certain that all of this is done.
Galilee,
with a message for a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to Joseph from the family of King David. The angel greeted Mary and said, "You are truly blessed. The Lord is with you." Mary was confused by the angel's word and wondered what they meant. Then the angel told Mary, "Don't be afraid. God is pleased with you, and you will have a son. His name will be Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of God Most High. The Lord God will make him king, as his ancestors David was. He will rule the people of Israel forever, and his kingdom will never end." Mary asked the angel. The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come down to you, and God's power will come over you. So your child will be called the Holy Son of God." Mary said,
thank you. asleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. All morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. Join in praising God. Praise God in heaven. Praise God on earth. Peace on earth to everyone who pleases God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Let's go to Bethlehem and see what the Lord has told us about. When Jesus was born into the village of Bethlehem in Judea, Herod was king. During this time, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem and said, "Where is the child born to the king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about this, he was worried, so was everyone else in Jerusalem. Herod secretly called to the wise men and asked them when they had first seen the star. He told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, let me know. I want to go and worship him too."
Bearing gifts, we traverse afar, field and fountain, morn and mountain, following yonder star. Star, wonder, star of light, star with royal beauty light, westward leading still proceed, guide us to thy perfect light.
They knelt down and worshipped him. They took out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh and gave them to him.
Once again, Jesus spoke to the people. This time he said, "I am the light for the world. Follow me and you won't be walking in the dark. You will have the light that gives light." As Christians, we know that the message of Christmas is that Jesus was human, that he was a great leader born to be king, but also so much more, that he is God himself. The world needed, we needed, I needed a savior, and that savior is Jesus. Jesus, the light of the world. Why don't you join the choir in singing "Hark the Herald Angels Sing"?
Glory to the Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Let me say that again. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. I heal a Jesus. Oh, Jesus. I get joy when I think about. Oh, Jesus. J-E-S-U-S. On Christ the solid rock, I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Jesus, the light. Jesus, the lily in the valley. Jesus, the light of the world. Oh, I don't know about you, but I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. Y'all don't have to have church for me. I know how he set me free and how he gave me the victory. Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus, oh, Jesus. Jesus, oh, Jesus. Get it for yourself. I get it for mine. Yeah. All right, all right, all right. This is a homily. This is a homily to Dr. David Sr., our pastor. We thank God for you, to our First Lady, Sister Green, to your awesome family that we love afar and anear, on live and everywhere, to the officers, members, choirs, all of the participants, all the members viewing out, Lottie, Dottie, everybody, to my family that came, to Brittany, to Zai, to Kai, and to my Lord and Savior who keeps on keeping me. Turn to your Bible. We're going to be reading from Luke chapter 2, verse 6. Again, Luke chapter 2, verse 6. My battery is on 19%, so that means I will be quick. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. Because, why? There was no room for them in the inn. Can I preach this morning from the subject title, Who Would Imagine a King? When you're talking about walking into the light for the Christmas nativity, I believe a few people could not have imagined a king. You all know the story very well. It's time for Mary to deliver Jesus. Mary and Joseph have had to go away from their home where they have made comfort comfortable, where they have food, where they have shelter, where they are ready to conceive the baby Jesus. But here it is, Caesar Augustus. He declares a census. Now they've got to leave their comfort and get out of their comfort and go to go pay some taxes and to go and put their names on the roll. Now they got to leave their comfort zone to do something else. And at this moment, we find that now Mary says, Joseph, the baby's coming. It's time to give birth. And at this moment, they go looking for a place to have Jesus. I wish I had a praying church. They go looking for a place to bring the Son of Man into this world. And as they go knocking at the Holiday Inn, and as they go knocking at the Ritz-Carlton, and as they go knocking at the Red Roof Inn, or wherever they can find, there's no room in the inn. Who would imagine a king? In fact, there was no room to the point they had to go and conceive Jesus in a barn, in a stable. And the manger is a pretty word, but it is a word that describes a vessel that you feed the animals from. And I know my Jesus is the bread of life, but I wish he wasn't born in a manger. I wish I had a praying church, a manger where they hold this food and feed animals. What's interesting is that even though the city was packed and Mary and Joseph had no room for Jesus, the Emperor Caesar Augustus, I'm sure they had a place for him to sleep. I'm sure his reservation was checked and verified, and they had a place for him to sleep. If his wife was pregnant, there would have been a place for her to give birth to her child. I wish I had a praying church. It was because they knew who Caesar was. They knew he was the king. They knew he was royalty. They knew who Caesar was. That's why he had a place. However, they did not know at the time what was in Mary's womb. they did not know that she was about to give birth to the Son of Man, who would save man from their own selves. And they told her, no room for the king. I wish I had a praying church. They refused to give her the best. Nobody knew King Jesus was coming into the world. This brings me again to the subject title, Who Could Imagine a King? Many of us are in a season where there is no room for us. You've experienced shutdowns and shutouts and experienced disappointments and denials. But it's only because they can't imagine that you know a king. They can't imagine that you're going to make their company better. That's why they didn't hire you. They can't imagine you're going to make the church better. They can't imagine that you're talented and gifted. They can't imagine what all you have inside of you waiting to come out of you. They can't imagine that you're a royal priesthood, that you come from a lineage in Christ Jesus, and you are blood bought. They can't imagine a king. Y'all pray with me. Somebody turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, who would, who could, who will imagine a king? Turn to your other neighbor, say, other neighbor, who could, who would, who will imagine that I'm royalty? I wish I had a praying church. When you're imagining a king, I only have two things for you to think on for this Christmas season. Two things for you to live by in the coming years. It's to accept and to acknowledge. You say accept and acknowledge. A lot of times people get these two things very confused. Accept means to consent to receive. In other words, acceptance is a decision. It's in your mind. But acknowledgement means that you had to accept the validity or legitimacy. In other words, you accept and recognize by making a gesture or confirmation. In other words, acceptance is a decision, but acknowledgement is a response to the decision you've made. So to my first point, when you really imagine a king in 2023 going into 2024, you must accept the king. I wish I had a few folks who accepted the king. One of the biggest reasons people cannot imagine a king when they see a king is because they will not accept the king when the king does not come in normal forms. I wish I had a praying church. Don't worry, I'm coming at your door. People did not accept David as the king when he was anointed at first, because he was just a shepherd tending to the sheep in the field. They could not imagine a king. When you run down 42 generations, here is King Jesus. People refused to accept King Jesus because he was born to a Virgin Mary and to a carpenter who was his father Joseph. It does not sound like king behavior to me. Can I tell you that if Jesus couldn't make folk accept him, what make you think people gonna accept you? I wish I had a praying church. So stop waiting. This is the start right here. Stop waiting for folk to accept you, to approve of you, to assure you, to affirm you, because before you were formed in your mother's womb, God already knew you. He already accepted you. I don't need nobody. Vicky Winder say, long as I got King Jesus, I don't need nobody else. Who would imagine a king? Not only must you accept, but you have to acknowledge. And when you acknowledge, that means I've made a decision that he's my king. But now I gotta act like he's my king. I've gotta respond that he's my king. How do you acknowledge that he's the king? You make room for the king. In our lives, we must make sure that we are not the one telling Jesus there's no room for you. It's time to declutter and make room for Jesus. How do you make room for Jesus? I'm glad you asked. That means you got to make time for Jesus and pray every day. You've got to make time for Jesus and read your word and study your Bible. You make room by making sure that you consider first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. So all of what is given to the king will be added unto you. Do I have a praying church? Let me finish it out here. When a king or queen comes to town, you make preparations for them, don't you? You make make sure the roads are clear and celebrations are set up. So that lets me know when we make room for the king, we're making room just to celebrate him, because we were made to make his praise glorious. So when you drop down to verse 13 through 14, it says, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. In other words, when it was announced that the shepherds that Jesus had been born, they were celebrating Jesus in heaven. The shepherds were celebrating Jesus under the stars. The wise men were celebrating Jesus on this Christmas. Can we imagine a king that we already know? We ought to celebrate. Stand to your feet and celebrate King Jesus with me. Why do we celebrate? Because his name is Jesus. Why do we celebrate? Because the name is Wonderful Counselor. Why do we celebrate? Because the government lie upon his shoulders. Why do we celebrate? Because by his stripes we are healed. Why do we celebrate? We can claim healing. This is for the worshipers in the house that will begin to stretch your hand toward heaven and begin to cry out, glory in the highest. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Thank you for Christ Jesus. We can shout and celebrate this morning because we believe in the King. Long live the King. What do we believe, AME Church? I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead and ascended into heaven and sit on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From this we shall come to judge the quick and the dead. What do we believe? I believe in the Holy Spirit. I believe in the church universal. I believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here because I imagine a king.
Oh, before. Until he comes again, I'll be singing about Jesus.
Come on, come on, come on. Come on, let's give God some praise. Let's give God some praise in this house. Come on, let's give God some praise for the newborn king. Just imagine how the angels and the shepherds felt when they saw the newborn king. We praise God today for the word. We praise God for the worship through music and dance. We praise God for this moment, this time, to be able to share with family and friends in this season as we come through this year. And I say we come through, because many of us have had some challenges this year.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But we were able to come through. Yeah. And to be able to see a brand new year, because he brings new hope and new joy.
Yeah.
New peace. New hope, new love. It's guaranteed by the promise of Jesus. There's something that we must do. We got to receive him. We got to invite him into our lives. We got to invite him into our walk. Many of us have dreams and visions, hopes and desires. They'll never come on our own. But with Jesus today, all things are possible. You can have new life. You can have new joy. You can have new hope. You can have new peace and even new love today. If you don't know him today, you need to know him. I offer to you him, to Jesus, to you. Before you on our screen, for those who are worshiping virtually, if somehow you've been impacted, encouraged to be a part of this church family, we would love for you to be a part of our church family. Somehow you have got lost in this year, and you need to rededicate, and you have a desire to be restored. Before you on our screen, the message that you may contact us. There might be someone in this sanctuary who want a relationship with Jesus, who want a church home, who need a church home, who desire a new walk and a new way. I invite you to be a part of this church family. Be a part of this church. I invite you to come now. Make a commitment. Anchor down. And grow and develop and become the man and woman of God that God has called you to be. Don't let your past stop you. Nothing can stop you from what God has destined you to be. Will you come? There is nothing better than knowing Jesus.
He will pick you up and turn your life
You ought to know him today.
You ought to
get to know him. Right now, right now. Just come. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Come on,
come on,
come on.
Come on, come on.
Come on,
come on.
Come on,
come on. Come on, come on. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. God is faithful. Want to lift up these two today. My brother Rashawn had a car accident on Friday. Went to the hospital and was released, but body still is in pain. So we lift him up right now. Thank him for pressing his way to the house of God today. Want to bless these two and pray for them right now. There might be others who have gone through this week unexpected challenges. It caused you to a point of almost breaking. But because you are here today, it represents the opportunity for you to invite God in. And if you invite God in, you don't have to carry it all by yourself. What weighs us down and burdens us down is that we are trying to carry it by ourselves. But today, if you need to release, even before this new year, some things that you are carrying, you just need to release it. The altar is open for you today. Altar is open for you today. Join these persons as they stand at this altar. Before I pray, if that's you today, you may come. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. God, we come before you around this altar. You know what we're going through. You know what every person in this, standing at this altar, stand in need of. You know what they are carrying today. You know what they carried all year long. You even know the secrets of our heart. So today I thank you for moving on their heart to come down to this altar and to put it in your hands. Some have come right now, God, because they need healing right now. We stand firm on your Advent promise that you were wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. Chastisement of our peace lie upon your shoulder, and by your stripes we are healed today. So in the name of Jesus, whatever emotional, spiritual, whatever right now, God, pain, whatever struggle right now, God, we're believing that you can heal it today. In the name of Jesus. So right now, God, we're going to come at this altar. And we're going to speak your word into our situation. The only thing we're going to do is speak your word right now, God. In the name of Jesus. Everybody assembled at this altar and standing right now, just speak the word after me. Put your name in this word today. Lord, I stand in need of healing. And I'm believing for David Green that you were wounded for my transgressions. You were bruised for my iniquities. And the chastisement of your peace, of my peace, light upon your shoulder, and by your stripes, David Green, say your name. David Green, say your name. Say your name. Say your name. Say it louder like you believe it. Say it like you're receiving it. It's healed today. Is healed. Is healed. In the name of Jesus. Let the church say amen. Come on, let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Come on, come on. Come on. Come on. Keep on speaking the word in your situation. Say this behind me. Greater is he that is within David Green than he that's within the world. Right now, God, we claim it right now in the name of Jesus. I, David Green, is the head and not the tail. Come on, speak that word. Speak that word right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, speak this word. We right now, in the name of Jesus, we that wait on the Lord shall renew our strength, shall run and not be weary, shall walk and not faint. Come on, give him some praise for the word. Give him some praise for the word. In the name. In the name. In the name of Jesus. I receive it. I receive it. I receive it right now. Come on, put those blessed hands together. Like you know you. It's already done. Come on, it's already done. Declared as a testimony. Before you leave, tell three people right now, it's already done. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. It's already done. It's already done. Oh, it's already done. In the name. In the name. In the name. In the name of Jesus, it's already done. In the name of Jesus. Come on, order my steps in the word. In your word. In your word. Show me how to walk. In your word. Come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. Please. I want to walk worthy. According to fulfill. But one thing we know. Come on, come on and give him some praise in it. Come on, give him some praise in it. Come on and give him some praise. This is the point where God just takes over. This is the point of worship where healing is available. This is the point of worship where deliverance is the. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Come on, come on. If you got a spirit of worship in you today, if you got a spirit of worship today, come on, let's worship him today. He's worthy to be worshiped today. I'm trying to tell you, healing is available in here today. Deliverance before 2024. You don't have to wait to 24. You can shout right now, today. I feel like the angels and the shepherds today. Oh, come, let us adore him today. Come on, come on, let's worship him today. Oh, come. Oh, come, oh, come. Now this is what I want. This is what I want. I want the hallelujah choir to sing. I want the hallelujah choir to sing. Hallelujah is for those who've been sick and the Lord has healed your body. That's the hallelujah choir. Those who've been down and the Lord has picked you up. That's the hallelujah choir. Those who didn't think you were going to make it, but you made it anyway. That's the hallelujah choir. That's what I want to sing right now and worship him. Can I get the hallelujah choir to stand on your feet and just say, he alone, nobody else, but he alone is worthy. He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy. Nobody but he. That's why I made it. That's how I made it. That's how I got here today. He alone. Come on. Come on, hallelujah choir. Hallelujah choir. Hallelujah choir. He alone. Him, adore him. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Put those blessed hands together if you can and give him a praise in this house. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord for your presence. Praise the Lord for your presence. Praise the Lord for your word. Praise the Lord for your worship in spirit and in truth. Praise the Lord today for this day. You are worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm glad I'm a part of the hallelujah cry. Hallelujah. Lord, you're worthy to be praised. When I think about where you brought me from, think about how far you be. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Come on. I just want to celebrate all of our visitors worshiping with us today. Any visitors worshiping with us? Any visitors worshiping with us? Will you please stand and just acknowledge yourself? Just acknowledge yourself. I think we are celebrating Sister Trimble's birthday. Let the church say amen. Amen. Hallelujah. For that, will you give us your name, family, for Trimble family? Will you give us the name who celebrate your name and where you're from? Begin. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And you? Praise the Lord. Happy to have all of you all in worship with us today. God bless you. Did I get the one in the back there? Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Good to have you to be with us. It's always good to have family, those who grew up in our church family, to come home for Christmas, come home for the holidays. If you're home for the holidays, will you please stand and just let us know where you from, where you are now? Yeah, let church say amen. Amen. I see Alice and Alexis. Amen. I think I see you. Please stand. Tell us where you, tell us where you, what you're doing. We want to know. We, where are you now? Praise the Lord. Amen. Just finished, graduated from where? Do I need to ask from where? Where you just graduated from? From fam, I didn't need to ask that. I just said from. The highest of the, okay, praise the Lord, the highest. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, y'all, that was a great day yesterday. I think you all are the champions, right? The football. Yeah, y'all just had a great day. All damn, you just had a great weekend. Amen. Amen. Yeah. I see Sister Parker with a fan. Amen. Church say amen. Amen. Now just behave now. Behave. Don't get. Praise the Lord. Amen. Do we have announcements?
Bible Discovery Hour is now in person every Sunday morning at 8:45 a.m. And as a reminder to members of NCAM, choir rehearsal will be held today after worship. We are pleased to announce the continuance of the transportation ministry. If you are in need of a ride to the church, please contact a member of the church office to make formal arrangements. The St. Stephen Child Care and Learning Center presents The 12 Symbols of Christmas, a Christmas production, Wednesday, December 20th, 2023 at 10 a.m. Christmas Eve worship celebration will be held December 24th at 10 a.m. Our Christmas morning worship celebration will be held virtually Monday, December 25th, 2023 at 10 a.m. Our New Year's Eve worship celebration will be held Sunday, December 31st, 2023 at 10 a.m. And then our New Year's Eve watch night celebration will be held on December 31st, 2023 at 10:45 p.m. Both services will be in person and virtual. And you are reminded to like, comment, and subscribe to all of our social media platforms.
Amen. Let the church say amen. Also, an announcement that was not all youth, as we prepare now for the Black Heritage, youth and parents. You got talent. God wants to use you. Singers, dancers, musicians, ushers, poet. We want to ask that you would meet Sister Lamont Wright and Sister Ebern to prepare for the Black Heritage. Right in the conference room. Let the church say amen. Now, didn't we see some talent in here today? Let the church say amen. I got it all. I got it all from 8:45 to the end of this worship experience. We have had a wonderful worship experience and a worship day. And I just want to praise God for the MCAM and the music ministry, the drama ministry, all that you have done today to make a wonderful day of worship. Thank you very much. I'm going to open up today thanking the MCAM under the direction of our music ministry and the drama ministry. Let church under the direction of Sister Walter, Donna Walter, and then Sister wrote the skit today. Someone. Sister Phyllis Walker wrote the skit this morning, and then I'm gonna move to the dancers. Wasn't the dancers? I mean, the dancers. I'm out of order this week. I'm out of order today, but I just wanna thank God for this ministry, and then the music ministry, the choir. Amen. I wanna thank God for you. Amen. And praise God for you. Amen. We had some new dancers. That was Brandon. Amen. Brandon Brown. Amen. Young man. He danced out of his soul. And then Brother Davis wrote a song. Amen. A Christmas song this morning. And he sung that song this morning. Oh, man. We're just praising God today for a wonderful day, let the church of MCAM Music Ministry. Oh, my drama, I got to say something else. Don't want to forget you, amen, amen. So all of you, we thank you again for the worship and the preacher. Let the church say amen. They incorporated all of that into worship today, and we praise God for them. So we thank God for our ministers, serving ministers. Thank God for our servant stewards, Sister Parker and Sister Henderson. Let church say amen. Thank God for our servant stewardesses and all of our stewardesses. Amen. Let the church say amen. We thank you for, is that Sister Brenda Holland? No. That's Harry. Okay, that's the sister. You're looking like your sister today. Praise the Lord. Amen. God bless. Maybe because you got your Sunday morning clothes on today. Let the church say amen. God bless you. Amen. Praise God for our deaconess, and we're glad to have Sister Deaconess Raffner with us. Let the church say amen. And Sister Betty Jones. Let the church say amen. Our serving trustees. We thank God for all of our trustees and the ministry that you are doing. And we praise God for our security inside and out. Praise God for our stewardship committee, our ushers. Let the church say amen. Praise God for our ushers, and we thank God for our ushers. Our ushers are doing a tremendous job, and we just want to say thank you again for all that you're doing. We got a new member. Don't you have a new member also? Sister Nelson, Charlotte? Charlotte Nelson, is she? Where she at? Stand up. I want to encourage all new members. Where? Raise your hand. She here? She still here? Charlotte? Charlotte? Where's Charlotte? Charlotte. That's going to Charlotte. Amen. Amen. Welcome to the usher board, Sister Nelson. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. God is good. She said, who, me? Amen. Praise the Lord. And we just thankful, amen, to all of that serve. Transportation Ministry, thank you for all that you're doing. You're getting all of the vehicles back in order. You're getting the schedule. And thank you again. Let's give the Transportation Ministry a big hand. Let the church say amen. Our Nurses Guild, let the church say amen. Our administrative team, our IT ministry, we wouldn't be able to do what we are doing without you. So we recognize you. We want to let you know just how much not only the pastor, but the church family appreciate what you are doing in the ministry. Let the church say amen. And then to Sister Kimberly Green, let the church say amen. We're thankful for you. Let the church say amen. Praise God for you. Amen. God is good. And all the time is good. Let us bless the Lord and continue to bless the Lord. This has been a wonderful day. All hearts satisfied. All minds clear. Let us all stand. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. May the love of Jesus the Christ, the sweet communion of the saints, the fellowship of all believers, rest, rule, and abide with you henceforth and forever, we pray. And the church said,